Good evening. Hello, hello. Good evening. Good evening, Ana María.
Good evening, teacher.
How
How
was
are you?
your day? Fine.
Fine, thank you, new teacher.
Fine. And your day off? How was your day off? ¿Tu día libre, cómo le fue?
No me entendí.
Day off, day off. O sea, cuando no van a hacer nada de lo que normalmente hacen. Ese es
I
el.
was. Okay, será así como I was to rest.
Ah, you went to tourist. Where
Yes.
did you go?
In my house.
Ah, okay. So you rest most of the time. Okay, and do you have still a presentation to say, or you already say it? ¿Tiene todavía una presentación que leer o ya la dijo?
Ah, yo ya la dije, Tita.
Ah, vale. Okay. Esperemos a los otros entonces.
Sí, solo usted y yo estamos.
Sí, just you and I. Just
Faltan varios, teacher.
somos como veintitantos que
Sí,
normalmente
faltan.
entran.
Sí, sí,
Hello,
sí,
hello. Entró y se fue.
Oh.
Alguien entró y se fue.
Siento, es que faltan unos 2 minutos, quizá por eso, Tita.
Sí, no, sí falta. Yo creo que solo vinieron a comprobar cómo estaba el asunto. O se le bajó la señal, porque cuando hay señal baja, el mismo Zoom lo saca.
Sí, eso es cierto.
Hay unas buenas que hacen falta. Este está interesante.
Esa le van a decir ahora, esa falta, ¿verdad?
No me acuerdo si ya la dijeron o si fue.
Yo
Ah,
hasta
no,
no
yo
me
creo que
acuerdo.
esta ya la dijeron.
De veras.
Ya la dijeron. Voy a preguntar, pero creo que esta ya la dijeron. La cosa es que como yo ya las leí todas,
Ajá.
entonces no me acuerdo cuáles son las que ya pasaron y cuáles son las que no han pasado. Pero como yo ya todas las leí.
Sí, no, yo de esto no me recuerdo. Aunque yo soy olvidadiza, dice.
Esta es la que dicen que hay hasta una película sobre esto. Que la encontraron en un tanque de agua. Pero aquí en ese hotel han habido diferentes. O sea, no es solamente eso que sucedió, que se perdió esa muchacha y la encontraron. Ahí en el tanque de agua, sino que ya han habido otras cosas. O sea, por ejemplo, aquí dice que el que vivía en el 14avo por muchos meses, en 1985, ma mató a 14 personas. Hubo otro que había matado a tres prostitutas mientras vivió allí. Y después que una mujer saltó por una de las ventanas del hotel se mató a ella y mató a un transeúnte sobre el que ella
Y
cayó.
la película, ¿cómo se llama?
En Netflix dice que está, lo voy a buscar. Se llama Crime Scene, The Vanishing at the Cecil Hotel. Es un documental. Crime Scene, así se llama, Crime Scene, The Vanishing at the Cecil Hotel. Lo voy a buscar ahí en Netflix. Ya vinieron otros dos compañeros. ¿No se acuerdan si
Sí.
esta ya la vimos? Hello.
No, esta no.
No la hemos visto.
Es la primera vez que comenzaron a leerla, creo que la dijeron. Una
Brivette.
chica creo que lo leyó.
Brivette Guido. Cuando venga Brivette le vamos a preguntar. Como le digo yo a la compañera, que yo no sé, no me puedo acordar si ya pasaron o no, porque yo ya las leí todas. Entonces para mí no son nuevas, ¿verdad? Pero no estoy segura si ya todos ustedes las escucharon o no. Bien, está ese The Vanishing at the Cecil Hotel. De Girola Mansion. Esta sí que sé que no la han visto. El South Korean Urban Legend. Y Soraya. ¿Qué dice? Experiences. En Ingrid Serna de Weeping Woman. Y esta de la carretilla Llorona. Que no la enseñé la vez pasada. Ah, permítanme. Esto se tiene que borrar. Ah, lo voy a compartir. Solo para borrarlo. Eso. A ver. So, how was your day yesterday? Did you go to your hometown? Hubo unos que me dijeron que iban a ir, pero no sé si fueron. Your hometown es su pueblo natal. Digamos, usted puede estar viviendo, qué sé yo, en Santa Tecla y ser de Usulután o ser de Santa María Ostuma. Y entonces, en épocas así, va a your hometown. Have you been to your hometown? ¿Estuvieron en su hometown? No.
No, teacher, San Salvador.
You stay in San Salvador, okay. What about you, Nady? Did you stay where you live or you went to your hometown?
Live in Santa Ana, teacher.
Ah, you live in Santa Ana. Nice.
Yes.
Do you live near the stadium? No.
Near.
Ah, you live near the stadium.
Yes.
Okay. I knew the places there.
Yes.
I like Santa Ana. We used to travel a lot to Santa Ana when I was young. Well, and
Oh.
when I was older too. You know, I used to went up to Metapan. And I used to go to the stadium in Metapan.
Metapan.
Yes, to watch the match with the matches with the team from Metapan, que es against any other. But they used to start at 9 and finish at 11. So I traveled from Metapan to San Salvador at 11 at night. No, no, they started at 7 and finished at 9. And from 9 to 11, I traveled from Metapan to San Salvador. Because it takes about 2 hours to get to San Salvador. I used to go with my little son. He was about 6 or 7 years old when we used to go to the matchings. It was the time when Isidro Metapan used to be the champion. So it was worthy. Okay, well, let me ask if the owners are here. Anda por aquí el que me mandó el de la de Girola Mansion in El Salvador.
Yes, teacher.
Do you want
I
to
am. I am maybe. Yes, yes.
Okay. Now let's see. Okay.
The Girola Mansion in El Salvador.
That's view the Girola of Mansion. The
Girola Mansion. Mm-hmm. Others view of the mansion, side photo, interior photography.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Legends of El Salvador. It all started at the beginning of the 19th century with Rafael Maria Girola. Nobody knew anything about him. He only appeared one day walking in the streets of Zacatecoluca. His physical appearance attracted much attention. He was white, dark, sent to have refined manners. Without a bow, he was a European. Rafael Maria Girola married the Salvadorian Gertrudis de la Cotera y González. It is possible that he invested his money in indigo, since at that time the cultivation was still booming and Zacatecoluca was one of the main producers. In addition, it is possible that he was the one who promoted the transition from indigo to coffee, since the family is now for basing its work on this crop. This family,
just a minute. This is an indigo. This is an indigo tree.
Okay, this is
an indigo.
Indigo, tree. Indigo. Mm-hmm. Okay,
es lo que le llaman el añil.
Yes, yes.
Uh-huh. Okay.
This family occur a great preponderance in the country's export sector, and some came to become one of the seven largest and most powerful families. Those that control coffee crop and government institutions. The coffee business gave to Girola popularity were
social status.
No veo la palabra. Wealth and social status. The Girola family wanted all of Santa Tecla. When Nueva San Salvador was founded, the family donated the land, so it is recorded in the documents. The lands of the Girola extend from the current area of Lourdes Colón in La Libertad to the Basilica of Guadalupe, Antiguo Cuscatlán. The Girola were of the founding families of Nueva San Salvador. They built their house in the heart of the new city. This is current now as the House of the Eagles. So it was that little by little there were building an imposing Parisian style mansion of the slopes of the city of Santa Tecla, the majestic properties that today can be seen in Santa Tecla. As the mansion Girola, located in Las Colinas, the house and chapel adjacent to the children's home at Alberto Girola, amongst others. As it is already toward the beginning of the 20th century, legends become to emerge. People who claimed that there was nothing natural about this promotion, that there were suspicious things there. Workers told of strange sounds, chants, like that lived in the middle of the night, and so began the story of the Girola family and their pacts with the devil. In the first half of the last century, for example, it was said that one of the brothers on the family had a room with silver, making a small relief of a god in the sailing. Some have even come to sell certain stories involving the supposed slaughter of animals and even people.
Wait.
Creo que era la anterior, pero se ve una sombra arriba. It is said that the Girola had a pact with the devil and that each generation had to give a child and offer it to the devil because if they did not do their business, they were far apart. When some wanted money, he had to make a pact with the devil, go overnight to place along, smoke a cigar, make some prayers, burn incense, and summon the devil. Their house were saturated with images and pictures of saints. Their house always smelled of incense. They had hot water everywhere. They were extremely superstitious because they believed in spirit, faith, bad luck, and such things. According to popular culture, the businesses of the Girola family, because there was a member of the family who refused to give his offering and continue with the dare to give up one of his sons. It was then that the businesses went bankrupt, import collapses due to economic losses, family members began to die in accidents. On January 13, 2001, an earthquake occurred in El Salvador with a magnitude of 7.7 in the Richter scale. The airport, of course, had their consequence for the whole country. It was there that the so-called block Saturday occurred because of the earthquake and impress column of hair fell off the housing, burning more than 200 homes and leading to the death of nearly 1,000 people. Another 5,000 would be injured and more than 1,000,000 injured. In the context, is this appalling event something happening that could be described as a miracle? In the slabs that fill off its dimension, that clearly shows how this disappeared. It is possible to notice how the detachment goes directly toward the house and deviates just a few meters. Passengers behind to then resume its old direction. It is as if an invisible, incomprehensible force had pushed the slab and prevented him from touching this mansion. It was the home of the gorilla.
Okay.
In the same machine, es clear cómo la avalanche se desvió para esquivar la mansión de los Quirola.
Es esta que está aquí.
Arriba, arriba, arriba.
¿A dónde? ¿Aquí?
No, aquí, ahí, por ahí donde está, pero a la derecha. Se ve un puntito acá. Esa es.
Híjole, estaba bien arriba.
Sí.
Era para que se la hubiera pasado llegando.
Sí, está de justo en la dirección.
Aquí
sí.
Venía.
Así es. Y milagrosamente se debió unos metros para pasar atrás de ella.
Uh-huh.
Y luego todo el desastre abajo. Y qué increíble que solo ella quedó arriba.
Uh-huh. Bueno.
The mansion business. It is most interesting to the abandoned the house of the gorilla, the supreme proof that something strange happened with that family, whether because of a pact with the devil or something of blessing. The truth is that the mansion served the inquiry again or all odds. In a way that many consider not only strange, but almost unnatural. The house is now abandoned and is the place of many visits by young people who say that it can feel something strange.
Okay. Hubo, there was a kind of report about it recently, I think. Creo que hace poco hicieron un reporte sobre la mansión Girola, así como de esos que Univision y todo eso.
Ah.
Tengo idea que vi uno de un reporte que como que they interviewed the people that worked there and they let them go inside and told them stories about what happened in the mansion.
Es una historia bien interesante.
Yes.
Y extrañamente ya no hay, todos de la familia murieron inexplicablemente, accidentes, sí. Enfermedades.
Sí.
Y las propiedades están aquí como
abandonadas.
Así, abandonadas.
Nadie se hace cargo de nada ahí.
Así es, bien
supuestamente,
extraño.
Supposedly, if there is nobody in the family, the government has to get them and do something with them. Supuestamente, si ya no hay nadie de la familia, el gobierno debería de tomar posesión,
sí.
Y hacer algo con ellas, pero nunca nadie ha querido tocar nada.
Sí, extraño.
And there are other properties also in San Salvador.
Yes.
From similar families and the similar thing that they had something with the devil. The mansions are there, but nobody uses them. Nadie las utiliza. Aunque sea museo, deberían de hacerlos.
Sí.
¿Verdad?
Yes.
Now, Soraya is here? No? The one from the Weeping Woman? Tampoco? And what about La Carreta Llorona? No? And Ingrid Serna is here? No? And what about the one that talks about the grandparent, my grandparent? Is here? My grandparents' house?
Oh, yes, teacher, it's me, Marco.
Okay, do you want to read it?
Yes, please.
Okay, let me see. Okay, now, let me get closer.
I send you a PowerPoint presentation.
Also?
You got it? Yeah. No.
I just got the PDF.
Oh.
Let me see. Let me see. Just a PDF. I just got a PDF. That is my grandparent. Or yeah. do you have? Let me see. Did you send it to the
WhatsApp?
In the WhatsApp group?
In the WhatsApp group, yeah.
Okay, let me see. Maybe I haven't seen it. A ver. ¿Por dónde está? Vamos a ver. ¿Qué día lo mandó supuestamente? Horror Story, Marvin Salazar. Oh, my grandparents' house.
Yeah.
Yes, I have it here. Y aquí tengo otra también. No, no las había visto. This one. Okay, let me show you. That one?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Okay.
It's a very short story.
Yes, don't worry.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. That's my grandparents' house was a nice place in the countryside where all the cousins met for school holidays. The most exciting thing we did was to stay up during the night because near our bedroom, they had planted several mango trees that dropped delicious fruits every time the wind blew strongly.
Okay. At give that me the, moment?
Give me the next one, please. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
At that moment, all the cousins who slept in the same room ran to see who first found the mango fruit in the middle of the darkness. One night, when we went out in search of the delicious mangoes, in the middle of the darkness came to us a shadow that with a very hoarse voice exclaimed, "Whoever I catch first, I will take it." And without thinking about anything, we ran at full speed until we reached the bedroom with our hearts beating strongly.
Wow. Who knows?
The next day, we realized that an uncle who had mental problems has played us a bad joke that almost killed us with fear.
Wow. It was a bad man.
it's a really story.
Yes.
It's anecdotic.
Any of you have any question for your friend? No questions. Usted pregúnteles a ellos entonces. Have any of you had a strange thing that ever happened to you? ¿Alguien ha vivido alguna cosa extraña? Yo he vivido varias. Creo que les conté una de ellas cuando mi papá se llegó a despedir de mí. Esa es una. Ya había tenido yo así experiencias con fantasmas. There was a man that he used to be a German surgeon. O sea, un sargento de la guerra de la Segunda Guerra Mundial. And he, when the Russians won, they took him to the Siberian jails that they had, camps that they had. Lo llevaron a uno de los campamentos de allá en Siberia. But many people tell good things about him, and they let him go on the last train that came out from Siberia. En el último tren que salió de Siberia, after the with soldiers that they released. And they say that they will pay him a ticket to wherever he wanted to go. And he decided to come to El Salvador. And they pay him everything to come here because he was a good man. I know because I have seen many movies about the German and the Second War and all that. And I know that there were very vicious people there in the army. But in his case, since he was an engineer, that's why he got a position as a surgeon. But he didn't let any of his crew, ninguno de su tropa, to kill anybody during the war. What they used to do is that when they were on the fields and they found a corpse, cuando encontraban cuerpos, they made big holes and buried them, and they used their guns to the hole. They used the guns in the hole because every time they get back to the quarters, they check if they have used the guns. But he didn't let any of his troops to kill anybody, but they used the guns because they checked them. And they buried the corpse that they found. And also, if they can help anybody, they help them to escape. And that's why he was released from Russia. Por eso lo dejaron que se fuera de Rusia. Because he had somebody talk for him. O sea, alguien habló por él. O sea, de que sabían que no era de los que mataban gente. And I when we met him here, and I used to call him daddy. Yo le decía papá. And he showed me how to cook different typical pastry from Germany. Él me enseñó a hacer repostería alemana. And when he was killed in El Salvador, cuando lo mataron en El Salvador, he died in a very horrible car accident. The owner of Toys, ¿cómo se llamaba este? Toys something. Hit his car. The man was drunk, and he hit his car from behind, and then he crashed with a pole, and he came out from the car, broke the window, the front window, and hit the pole with his head, and he was with all the brain out because he has a cut from here to here, all the brain out. But he remained alive for about a month, and he was always asking for me. I was about 8 years old by that time, and they let me go to see him at Instituto Salvadoreño del Seguro Social, the central one. They let me get in because they wanted to know if he can recognize me. And he did, he recognized me. And when I was there with him, he touched my head and he made like a pray for me. But it was, he didn't do it in Spanish, but in German. So I didn't know what he said. But it was like a pray for me. And then days later, he died. But he recognized me and he prayed for me. And all the family loved him a lot. And he has nothing to do with my mother, because I call him daddy because I want to call him daddy, not because he has something with my mother. And even my father was a friend with him, and he used to go to eat every day at home, my home. And my auntie worked with him. She was his secretary, and we had a very nice relationship. And one day, we were weeping for him all day, all the time. And once we were very near to Christmas time, and my mother and I decided to make the strudel, and the pastries that he taught us how to do it. And we were weeping for him. And then the cats, we had four cats, and all the cats were like, and we saw a very big like shadow, but white shadow, crossing from the living room to the patio. And the pantry where we were working was here. And then we saw the hands of him on the dove. And my mother and I look at each other. And then we say, we don't have to keep weeping for him. And we left all the dove and all the things there. And we go running to our bedrooms. And we promise not to weep for him anymore. Le llorábamos mucho. And it is a saying that you don't have to weep too much for somebody because you don't let them go to rest in peace. Cuando uno llora demasiado por un muerto, no lo dejamos que descanse en paz. Entonces, pero sí, o sea, nos dio miedo porque vimos las manos, porque vimos la como sombra, ¿verdad? No lo vimos solo nosotros, también los gatos, ¿verdad? Entonces dijimos, no, ya no vamos a llorar por él. Nos curamos ahí. But it was a very strange thing for us. I was about 8 years old. It was something very strange. Now, we have the owner of La Carreta Llorona. Jaime Barrera is here. Jaime Barrera is here, no? And what about Ingrid Serna? Can you hear me? Hello. ¿Me escuchan?
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Aquí dice alguien, Zulma Pérez dice que ella vivió algo extraño. She was with her brothers and her daddy from church, and they were in a rural area, and they get to the passages and they saw a bag in the middle of the passage, a black bag. And then the bag gets larger and larger, and it stands in two legs. It was a black animal, and its eyes were red like fire. And it was walking in front of them. Then, then they went to the main street and it disappears. The strange thing is that in that passage, there were a lot of dogs, but none of them bark. It could be, she said that it could be the black cadejo. She was 12.
And sí, como dicen de que el cadejo es el padre de los perros, ni uno ladrón.
Sí. No, well, you know one thing. There are people that said, especially Christian people, that say that these things don't exist. But all the things like witches and enchants and all that actually exist. If you notice, even in the Bible, it says that las brujerías, los brujos y los no sé qué más, y los hechiceros, los brujos y los hechiceros, no van a entrar al reino de los cielos. Entonces, si lo dice en la Biblia, es porque esas cosas existen.
Sí, ¿verdad?
Entonces, pero hay quienes dicen que la más grande mentira que dice el diablo es hacer creer a las personas que no existe y que no tiene nada que ver aquí. Pero una cosa es que exista y otra cosa es quién es mayor. Porque sí existen las cosas malas, pero Dios siempre es superior. Y si creemos en Dios, Él nos protege. Es más, los brujos y los hechiceros ocupan restos de personas para hacer sus encantos, para matar gente y cosas así. Pero ellos van a los cementerios a ver qué tipo de gente es al que llegan a enterrar. Cuando ellos ven que es un cristiano, a ese no lo molestan, porque es más, ni les sirve sus restos para hacer todas las brujerías que hacen, porque los restos de un cristiano están apartados por Dios. Entonces esas cosas no le funcionan a ellos. Entonces ellos ocupan a gente que saben que no le teme a Dios y que no creyeron en Dios y que para hacer sus cosas. Porque si ocupan algo de una gente que es de Dios, no les funciona para las cosas que ellos hacen. Entonces, pero de que existen esas cosas, existen. Pero Dios es mayor. O sea, él si Él lo está cuidando a uno, nadie puede en contra de uno. ¿Verdad? Entonces, pero de que las cosas feas existen, existen. Pero Dios es mayor. Entonces, por eso es que uno siempre tiene que estar de la mano de Dios. Porque si uno está de la mano de Dios, por más mal que le quieran hacer, no lo van a lograr hacer nada malo. Si, en la misma Biblia dice que hasta puede tomar usted veneno y no se va a morir porque Dios lo cuida. ¿Verdad? Entonces, aquí dice alguien más. I worked 12 years in a mill that is owned by the regalado. Ajá. And not that curiously, every year in each harvest, at least one person dies. And everyone said that the family has a lot of money because of their pact with the devil. And that pact is that each harvest the devil charges a soul to the family, but it charges the souls of the workers. In addition, in the evenings, many companions commented that strange noises were heard, and they saw shadows within the wood inside. There are rooms for employees, but sometimes they could not sleep because they say they were scared. Yes, I couldn't sleep there neither. You know, yo creo que donde está construida no es la Gran Vía, es la otra, ¿cómo se llama? La que construyeron los Robles. Que está cerca de la Gran Vía. Está la Gran Vía. Multiplaza. My brother got to finish Multiplaza because they never can get ahead, and they lost many people there, workers in that Multiplaza. And the Pomas paid an amount of money to the family to don't spread the things. O sea, le pagaron a las familias para que no divulgaran, pero se los habían llevado. Bueno, a mí mi hermano me tenía prohibido que si iba a Multiplaza, no bajara, si no había espacio para yo dejar el carro en la primera o en el segundo sótano, que nunca se me fuera a ocurrir bajar al tercer sótano. Porque en el tercer sótano ocurrían cosas feas. And also, the workers that were missed from there, they were seen.
Teacher, no escuchamos.
Sorry.
El espanto le apagó el micrófono.
Sí, no quiere que les cuente.
Ya no dio más miedo.
No, pero es cierto. Dicen que hay gente que, digamos, la gente que cuida en la noche ahí en Multiplaza, toda la vida andan en parejas, porque de repente se encienden los, o sea, ellos ya apagaron todo y ya todo está apagado, y de repente se encienden las que tienen esos como para subir
sensores,
no, y los y las
otras escaleras,
esas como las bandas esas, en fin, que de repente se encienden y ya todo estaba apagado, y dicen que la gente que trabaja en el supermercado de ahí del Selectos, también ya les han dicho que no anden solos, porque ahí vieron a los muertos que se habían desaparecido, así colgados, pero así como fantasmales, pero colgados. Oh. Ahí en el Super Selectos, que hubo una chica que casi se vuelve loca cuando los vio, pero porque andaba sola. Entonces les han dicho que nunca anden solos. Entonces mi hermano pudo terminar Multiplaza porque como mi hermano es cristiano, entonces él antes de empezar nada, él reunía a su equipo y empezaban a orar, y él les tenía prohibido andar solos. Entonces para poder terminar eso, solo así fue, a pura oración, porque eso está embrujado. O sea, ahí donde es Multiplaza. Pero mi hermano me tenía prohibido, no se te vaya a ocurrir irte al tercer sótano, nunca, así, prohibido. Entonces, yo por supuesto que yo casi trataba de llegar a Multiplaza lo menos posible, porque él es testigo de que cosas feas suceden ahí, ¿verdad? Entonces, a ver, Soraya no anda por aquí. ¿No? ¿Y el de South Korea?
Yes, Teach.
Vaya.
South Korean Urban Legend. Uh-huh. The toilet gas.
Mm-hmm. Okay, start.
The Korean people say that some teenager had committed suicide in public toilet for stress and bullying. And some people that had visited the water closet say the spirit remained in the place and had frightened them, because the spirit made then the next question, do you need the red or blue play paper? And then they cannot open the door and escape. And the next, please. ¿Me escuchan?
Yes.
¿Qué se hizo la teacher?
Quizás se volvió a congelar.
Ay, Dios.
Ya la llevó al espanto.
If you choose the red paper, the spirit will open the door with a vengeful face and start and disembowel you until the room turns red, covered with your blood. But if you choose the blue paper, the spirit will drown you with its bared hands until your skin changes to the blue color. The people say that the solution is to answer that you don't need the toilet paper. So in this way, you can escape. Also,
Some was uncomfortable due to dirt, but better dirty than dead.
So true.
Y agregué lo de la cross-cultural experience. But in my cross-cultural experience, I had visited the water closet in Korea, but I never had seen a ghost in the restroom. Regarded the different customs than Latin America. I saw that the greetings age other with a bow and not with hugs or kisses. You must take off your shoes when visit a Korean house. The Korean people to eat sit on the floor. I like some customs, but I don't like eating sit on the floor.
Okay.
If the boss is a drinker, the Korean cannot say no to an invitation from the boss.
Okay.
Thank you.
A mí me fregarían bien porque a mí no me gusta beber. Okay. Now. No ha venido todavía Soraya Araujo. Me va a tocar leerlo a mí. Porque la vamos a terminar hoy. Porque para mañana, que todavía tenemos clase, vamos a... Mañana, alisten ustedes una presentación de ustedes y qué es lo que hacen, o sea, en qué trabajan o dónde estudian, your hometown, o sea, de dónde es su familia. Porque una cosa es que usted haya nacido en tal lugar, pero su familia, ¿de dónde usted sabe que viene? Porque yo, por ejemplo, en mi caso, I am Salvadorian. I was born in San Salvador. O sea, yo he nacido en San Salvador. But my grandmother from my mother's side is from Nahuizalco. And my grandfather from my mother's side is from San Julián. So they are from Sonsonate. And my father's side is from Santa María Ostuma. Okay? But my family from my father's side came from Spain, from the La zona vasca, o sea, the Basque zone area. And they were Jewish people, but lo que le llaman judíos errantes, okay? And their last name was, in la zona vasca, they called them Echegoyen. But in El Salvador, they were called Echegoyen, okay? They had to quit from the Jewish religion because they were, that's why they were judíos errantes, because there was a time when Jewish people was always hunted. And then they, in order to subsist, they need to quit their religion, and they make themselves Christians or Catholics or whatever in order to keep alive. Okay. But that's my roots. That's all mis. This, prepare something like that, okay? And what are you doing now? Where do you work at? Because in order to know each other, okay?
Okay, teacher.
Y acuérdense de que tienen que tener su, lo de las oraciones aquellas que hicieron la vez pasada, en pasado en presente, en pasado perfecto, perdón. De had, el pasado participio. Porque lo vamos a estar así entre nosotros intercambiando. Okay, now. Soraya Araujo talked us about the experiences and about the maitro. Okay, the maitro. That is a common word in El Salvador. Okay. My work is not based on legends or myths, but on paranormal experience that even some are not scary and they are out of the ordinary. When my daughter was between 3 and 4 years old, now she is 19 years old girl, she was not afraid of the dark. She went anywhere in the house, even if the light was off. And because of the size, she still did not reach the switch of the lights. But suddenly, we began to notice that there was a part of the house in the living room, in a corner that she did not like to approach. Yet that part was not dark, but she did not like to go there. If a toy rolled on that side, she asked us to reach it. One day, playing, I began to take out what was happening to her, because she did not approach there, and she told me by there was a maitro. I was surprised because that word was not common. She heard it in the house. Nobody had that word in our vocabulary. Well, little by little, I was taking her out, and she said in the corner of the room and sometimes in the back room where there is a window and it is not dark at all, he stood, el maitro, and that scared her, describing him as a tall man who reached the false sky, the false sailing, it is false sailing, and dressed in black, and said that sometimes had red eyes, only that was look at him. She was really afraid. It was seen in her little face when suddenly she turned her gaze to that place. My little girl always walked with her sacramentals. I think maybe that's why she rejected what she saw and did not cause her curiosity to approach there. We immediately poured holy water and went to talk to the priest, who came to bless the house. After that, the girl did not see anything, but it is something she still remembers. It is worth mentioning that I or anyone else in the family ever felt anything strange or saw anything strange, only her. Bueno, eso, la cosa es esta, que en una familia no toda la gente tiene esa capacidad de ver cosas así. O sea, se requiere ser bastante sensible para ver cosas espirituales. Yo creo que en mi caso es en parte lo que les he contado, de que de parte de la familia de mi papá somos judíos errantes, y normalmente la gente judía, tienen bastante, como por eso mismo de ser la pueblo escogido de Dios, tienden a ser bastante sensibles, sensitivos. Entonces, bueno, no sé si ustedes saben, pero en los tabernáculos de ellos hay dibujados eso de los signos zodiacales. Entonces, porque los judíos tienen que ver mucho con cosas también así. Bueno, de Salomón dicen que él también hacía cosas de mucha espiritualidad y cosas así, o sea, vaya usted a saber. Ok. Me falta también del Farewell of My Grandfather, pero this is for next. Lo voy a revisar bien porque no lo había revisado. Ok. See you tomorrow. Ok. Take good care and prepare yourself to get an introduction of you. All of you will talk tomorrow. Ok. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Take care.
Good night.
Sleep well. Duerman bien, no estén pensando en cosas raras.